Well, Lloyd.
Oh, David.
Oh, you just caught me. I was just in the middle of practicing my boxinator blocks for the Belfast boxinator block. You've heard of those, right?
The Belfast boxinator block?
It's a new block. No one's heard of it.
Ooh, we could be on to something here.
Lloyd, how's things with you?
Terrible.
How's that?
It's because I have a backlog.
That sounds extremely serious, Lloyd. You should probably see somebody about that.
Not that kind of backlog. I have a block room backlog.
It's worse than I first thought.
Mm-hmm. You know that we had a poster here?
Oh yeah, the poster where we showed that the Belfast block room has virtually eliminated our need for recovery after upper limb surgery and reduced the interval time between cases by 70%. That poster?
Yes. However, we are now victims of our own success. Because we've realised that all of our patients are waiting to have full preoperative assessments.
But they don't need that.
I know, so we can't even fill our lists. Realistically, if you look at it, I think there are only three items of information that are required in order to proceed with upper limb surgery under brachial plexus block.
I think one of those would have to be giving the patient information in a way that they'd be able to understand and getting their consent for a block.
Perhaps even if you had made a patient information video and you could bring them in and show them the video.
Lloyd, that is brilliant.
Thank you.
Brilliant.
Thank you.
Number two.
I think number two would be any contraindications to having a nerve block. Well, there's not really that many, Dave, are there?
I guess patient refusal would be the main one.
Yeah.
And number three, reviewing their medications to ensure that they aren't on any anticoagulants that would preclude you from doing a block. That's it.
That's it. I don't need any more information, investigations, reviews, referrals, anything.
It would really beg the question as to why are we putting so many patients through pre-assessment in the first place and wasting a lot of the resources that could be utilised in other areas.
Why don't we create a streamlined pre-operative information and assessment service for patients having a weak upper limb surgery, and we'll only ask them the three pieces of information that we require.
Right, that's brilliant.
Thank you, David.
Let's do that.
Let's do it.
Preoperative assessment clinic. How do we think it went?
It went terrific. The patients seemed really relaxed. They enjoyed all the information they were given. I think they went off feeling well informed. The interview was very efficient. The patients and their relatives certainly found it very informative and very helpful, and definitely was a success.
We had 20 patients in approximately an hour and a half, and we provided them with a lot of information, and they loved the video as well. And everyone actually left with a smile on their face as well.